watching or whether you're in this room right now, where the Lord reintroduces himself to a generation and amplifies his message. Whether he says to Moses, tell the people that I am, or whether he says, tell them that I am your father, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, they come home, for he says it's important for you to know who I am. And whenever there's a generation that may forget who he is, he allows a message to stir around the world when it's in everybody's mouth at the same time to say, hello, I want to reintroduce who I am. I still do miracles.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Waymaker. Miracle worker. The Lord is Jesus is the miracle worker.
Amen.
Is with us today. And in that place where you now stand or sit in your own home, maybe you are at work, perhaps in a medical facility, a hospital, a nursing home. Mm-hmm. I want you to that we are here tonight to worship a God who is a miracle worker, who is a way maker. When you look around and you see no way out of your situation, just remember, don't you give up yet. Remember, take a minute to remember that you have a God, and this God is a way maker. He specializes in making a way where there is no way. He specialized in bringing a miracle because he is a miracle worker. Welcome again to our third and final day of coming together in prayer. But the prayers will not end tonight. We will continue to pray individually in our homes all this week long until Sunday. And of course, as people of God, we are to be praying people. We cannot help it but to pray. And so thank you again for joining me and for joining the sisters and brothers of the faith in Christ Jesus tonight. This is a great night of the Lord. God has a blessing for you and for me tonight as we gather together. Remember, God said, if you meet as one or two or three people, or even more than three people, but you are meeting and gathering in my name, and you dare to mention my name and call on my name, surely I will be with you. So hallelujah, my friends, God is with us tonight because we gather tonight in the name of Jesus to do nothing else but to praise him, to worship him, to adore him and to lift his name higher. We will do it by borrowing the songs from those who already put it together in nice recording, through this YouTube channel. We will do it by lifting our own voices in prayer. We will do it by singing along when the songs are presented. We will do it by praying nonstop, for God Almighty is about to do a greater thing, a new thing in our life. This is a weekend of Pentecost. We received the gift of the Holy Spirit. So the Lord is with us. God is in our midst. Hallelujah. And so let me just remind everyone to remain muted until the time when you have to say something, or if you have to pray or say something, just remember to unmute yourself first. If you are not the one talking at the moment, keep your mic muted. That way we will have a clear sound and an easy mutual understanding. So tonight, I bring a brief scriptural meditation taken from the book of the prophet Isaiah, one of the biggest prophets of the Old Testament, the prophet Isaiah, on chapter 54. Isaiah chapter 54. We are going to have just one verse to reflect upon, to meditate on, and the verse is 17. Verse 17 of chapter 54 of the book of the prophet Isaiah. Here's the reading of the word. No weapon forged against you will prevail, and you will refute every tongue that accuses you. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and this is the vindication from me, declares the Lord. Did you just hear what I said? Did you hear what I just read? This is a powerful word of assurance, that no weapon forged against you, no evil intentions being put together with your name attached to it, no demoniac forces of darkness, be them spiritual or human caused or natural cause, that are being planned with your name behind it, intended to harm you or destroy you or sabotage your life, sabotage your existence, will be successful, says the Lord. Oh my God. Do you know that the enemy, while we are here praising and worshiping and doing everything we can to praise and worship our Lord, the enemy is angry and upset, and he is trying to prompt something, to package something, and to mail you something, some poison of some sort, just to ruin your joy, ruin your life, ruin your health, destroy your family, sabotage your work, and just interfere with your academics if you are a student. The enemy is not satisfied, is not happy to see you happy, to see you joyful. The enemy wants you down. But God, you know, is really a miracle worker. He knows everything. He knows the plans of the enemy. And he knows how afraid we are when we see signs of the enemy. Sometimes you will notice the signs of the enemy, the evil one. The evil one is behind. Mind is after you. You will see everything, you will collapse around you. Everything, you will go down. Whatever you try is not going to prosper. You try this, it fails. Try that, it fails. Anything you touch will die. Those are signs of the presence of the enemy. And God knows the enemy's plan to destroy you. And he goes ahead and works things out for you. God is working things out for you and for me. And he's giving us a word of assurance tonight as we have gathered to pray to him, to take our petitions to God, to plead with God, to ask God specific requests, and to worship God tonight. God is saying to us, do not worry. Do not pay attention to the enemy. Don't worry. Don't give the attention to the devil. He's trying to intimidate you. He's trying to frustrate you. He's trying to defray you so you cannot make the next day. God is saying tonight, be joyful, be happy. Rise up and stand up. Keep your head up and keep your nose up and look forward and move forward. Keep going. Don't you stop. Don't pay attention to the enemy, because there is no weapon that the devil is going to set up for you that is going to work out against you, because I am your God and I'm going to neutralize the plans of the enemy against you, and your path will be cleared and you will march on. Keep marching on to your destination with God as your company. Oh my God. You know, we are really going through a lot in our lives these days. It is too much. This is not just about the pandemic. We as a people, we are going through a lot more disasters, much harder than the pandemic. Those are disasters that the vaccines cannot do anything to them. Doctors cannot resolve. And the enemy is hoping that we will collapse, we will give up, we will surrender. But God is saying, no, 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 no. The people known by my name will never surrender to the forces of wickedness and darkness. The people known by my name, they will call on me and I will come for their rescue. And the weapons that have been forged against them, they will not, they will not take off. When the enemy is trying to shoot, the bullet is not coming out of the gun. The gun will somehow break down. They will not target you and be successful, because you are a precious child of God. And so, my friends, welcome again with this word. Welcome and be assured that God is with us, just as he was with us before yesterday and yesterday. That same God has never changed, is with us again, and he will be with us tomorrow and all the days of our living. Let us give ourselves up to the Lord. Let us shout and call upon the name of Jesus. Let us continue to ring the bell on the gates of heaven today. Let us continue to knock on the door of the throne of God. There is life on God's throne. There's peace on God's throne. There is peace and unity and love and success and good health and everything we need. It is there on the throne of God. That's why we have gathered virtually tonight, to keep knocking on the door, because Jesus himself said to his disciples, he said, never give up praying, you know, and not every time you pray, you'll see it happen, come to pass right away. But that's not a reason for you to give up. Keep knocking on the door. Keep praying. Pray persistently. And he said, if somebody came to a house, a neighbor, and has the habit of just coming at night and knocking on your door, and you hear that person knocking on a door for the first time, and you're like, oh no, I'm sleeping. You're not gonna interrupt my sleep. I'm not coming there to open that door. And then you hear the person knocking for the second time, and then for the third time, and the person just keeps knocking. Aren't you just gonna get tired and wake up and go attend to the person so that you can have peace and get rid of that disturbance? That was Jesus talking. And then he said, for that reason, keep knocking on the door of my heavenly Father. If he doesn't hear you the first time, or he doesn't attend to you the first time, he will attend to you the second time. If not the second time, the third time. If not the third, the fourth. If not the fourth, the fifth. You know, the numbers are infinite. Keep knocking on the throne of God. And God, who is gracious and loving and kind, will definitely come to attend to your needs. Let us pray, my friends, let us pray. Oh God Almighty, Father God of heavens, Father and Lord of the universe, Father of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, God, the source of our lives, our origin, our Alpha and Omega, we have gathered tonight for the third consecutive night to do nothing else but to worship you, to go crazy in worship, in prayer, and thanksgiving to you. Lord, hear our prayers tonight, for your children have come Your children have gathered virtually. Your children, Lord, from both here in New York and elsewhere around this globe, they have gathered together tonight to worship you, to praise you, and to pray to you, to present petitions and requests. We have names of beloved ones. We have family members. We have our own selves. We have something that is wrong with our own selves. We have come to you, Lord, because you are the fountain of the living water. Your water provides for life. Lord God Almighty, we are here for you tonight. Hear our prayers and hear the outcries of your children. Those who are sick, grant them health. Those who have lost beloved ones, grant them comfort and provide, oh Lord, for the spirit of comfort. Those who are going through challenging life situations in their families, in their workplaces, with their children, their grandchildren, Lord, grant your mercy, for we have come because we believe. We have come together because we have faith. We know we can trust you. We can lean on you, Lord. You are trustworthy. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be worshiped. And so we are here to worship you. Receive our praise and worship tonight. Receive, O Lord, the music that brings honor and glory to your holy name. Receive the voices of men and women that will be lifted up unto you, bringing prayers for your beloved children. Lord, hear our prayers. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we bless your name. Amen. Amen. Okay.
Amen.
Yeah. So now we're going to listen to this second song. It is a prayer song for leaders because today, the theme for today's prayer, the general theme for this day is a prayer for leaders. We are praying for our pastoral leadership, for our laity leadership. We are praying for our staff members. We are praying for leaders in the different ministries of our church and the volunteers that come and help out our ministries. We are praying for children and youth. We are praying for young adults. We are praying for unity and the body of Christ. And we are praying for individual requests that will be presented. And so it is a night of prayer. So my friends, after this song, this prayer song for leaders, we are going to hear the voices of Sister Eloisa Hall, followed by Sister Myrna Woolcock, who will present prayers for pastor and staff, as well as leaders and ministry and volunteers, respectively. Let me share my screen first. Okay.
Why are people snagging this $89 portable AC? I recently discovered how to...
Sorry for these commercials. That's what happened if you used the YouTube...
Refrigerate music. Any room in my house in under 5 minutes.
Okay.
Our leaders, our nation, education, mental health, our families, our countries, our money. Our nation, education.
lift it all in prayer. Yes, Sister Eloisa.
Good evening, brothers and sisters in Christ. Peace. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh in us. Refresh us where we have become dormant and hardened by circumstances and uncertainty during the past year in tribulation. Revive, restore, and rejuvenate your people that we may receive the full blessing that is stored for us in heaven during this time of revival as we strive to grow in your presence. Almighty and everlasting Father, I pray, Lord, that you will look down from heaven and hear my humble prayer and let it be accepted to you in Jesus' precious name. Lift up your servant that you have called and sanctified as your elect one, Reverend Quissico, whom you also gave workers needed to fulfill the work in your kingdom for our salvation, that they be protected and sheltered from the temptation of the evil one in Jesus' name. Standing in your presence, the shepherd of the flock who runs the race of perseverance, that when he is tested will receive the crown of life, that you promise to those who love and are obedient to your will. Bless our pastor and his staff as the prayers of petition, intercession, and thanksgiving is offered up, giving him direction, guidance, and selfish wisdom, knowledge, and good recollection, that he may stand mature in the fullness of your will, and present today and always as a spiritual leader with the word of truth in his mouth. Let your word be his buckler and shield, and that he be able to disprove any tongue that may accuse him, so he will receive his heritage as your servant. And those who are lay person working side by side with the shepherd may be holy in all they do as Christ is holy. I pray, God, faith, hope, and love in them for each other, that they have a pure heart that is grounded and steadfast in no other one but Christ, without intimidation or humiliation, for the ministry they are gifted with. Let unity, clarity, and effort in doing work be directed by the Holy Spirit in his life for the spreading of the gospel for which he was baptized into. And may peace, love, joy be bestowed upon his family and friend from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. May the power of the Spirit of life and light of the crucified and risen Savior rest on Pastor Quissico and his staff, empowering them in their dedication and effectiveness in all they endeavor for God's kingdom and earth. Thank you, Father, for hearing and answering prayer in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
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 Sister Woodcock.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Father God, we come before your presence one more time. And we just want to say thank you. For indeed, Lord, are good. We thank you, Father God, for the many blessings that you have bestowed upon your children, for good health. We thank you for food you provide us. We thank you, God, for shelter, and we thank you for friends. God, we thank you for the leaders you have provided so that your work can be done here on earth. God, we ask that you will equip them so that, Father, lives can be transformed and souls will be born for your kingdom. Lord, we know we are your extension here on earth, and we need to do your will. But only by your Holy Spirit, Father, we will be able to do so. So we are asking you to empower us, gracious, loving God. Be with your children that you have called out to be leaders in your church, that they will continue to walk the pathway of righteousness. God, we pray that you will pour out your blessings upon them, that you will give them the extra strength, oh God, to go on, not to give up, but to know, Lord, that there is a crown awaiting them if they fail not. And so, Lord, we just look to you, you who art the giver of good gifts. Father, you know there's nothing that we can do without you. And so we are asking, Lord, to go before and to lead, to guide and to direct. Holy God, hear our prayers. Lord, we remember those who have given their lives, Father God, to do your will. Continue, Lord Jesus, to show up for them. Lord, we pray for those who have volunteered their time to be laboring in your vineyard. We ask you, God, a blessing will attend them, that they will grow from strength to strength. God, we pray that only you, Lord, we can depend on. And so we ask that you will go before us. God, we pray that you will guide our steps. Holy Father, consecrate us. And as we continue, Lord, to call upon you, the Almighty, will you renew us, Lord? God, create in us clean hearts, renew right spirit within us, and help us, Lord, to love as you have taught us to love. Oh God, we know that without your love, your unfailing love, we will all fail if we do not have that love. So Father God, hear our prayers. Continue, Lord God, to shower your blessings upon your people as they continue to do the work that you have given us to do. For Lord, we know that you cannot do it here on earth. So lead us on, we pray. Bless us as we continue to walk with us, Lord, and to give us the strength. Lord, at times we feel as if we cannot make it. But Lord, we know that if you stand by us, if you stand before us and behind us, then we know we can do all things. We can be conquerors. So Lord, help us. Teach us to depend on you, Lord. On you, Lord, and on you only. For you, God, will never leave us. You will never forsake us. Help us to stand on your promises. For we know, God, you are faithful. Hear our prayers tonight. Continue to be our God. Continue to guide our steps and to lead us in the pathway of righteousness. For in so doing, Lord, you ever will continue with you. Hear us, my request, for we ask all of it in the mighty name of Jesus, our Lord and our Savior.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Let us take a praise and worship song here. So this is a welcoming of the Holy Spirit song. Welcome, Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen, amen.
Welcome, Holy Spirit, and live inside of me. We shall proceed with our prayers. Sister Olivia Edwards praying for children and youth, and followed by Sister Sharelle Peters, who will pray for young adults.
As I begin to pray, I ask you that you would mention the children that you would have me pray for. As I'm praying, you can call the children's names out because I'm praying for all children and youth. Mm-hmm. So just mention your children's names as I pray. Whoever dwells in the shadow of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. They will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In him, I will trust. He will save us from the flowery snares and the deadly pestilence. He will cover us. 1,000 may fall at your side, but it will not come near you. He will command his angels to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you in their hands, so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. You will tread on lions and cobras and trample the great lions and serpents. The Lord will rescue you. He will protect you. He will answer you when you call on him. He will be there in your troubled times and deliver you when you call upon his name. Let us pray. Father, Mother God, In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we come before you. You said, let the children come unto me. So tonight, we bring all the children before you, the entire world's children and youth. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you for all our brothers and sisters, Lord, that is watching or listening to us tonight all over the world. We thank you because there is no distance in your glory. Wherever they are right now, Lord, we stand in agreement and we are asking for your mercy on all our children. Lord, with all the kidnapping of children, the sex trafficking, the violence, the gangs putting our children against each other, prayer pressure in schools, the foul language, the music, the dress code, child abuse by parents, and so many other things against our children and youth today. So Father, Mother God, we come standing in the gap for our children and asking your mercies and blessing and protection over them. We come before you desiring all that was mentioned in Psalm 91 for our children, to be free from all generational sins, iniquities, and that it may not have any influences upon them. We thank you for saving us and cleansing us from our sins. We confess and we say tonight, we belong to you, and that we dedicate our children and all their names to you right now in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We now confess and repent of our sins of knowing and unknowing in the name of Jesus and through his blood. We now renounce and ask that you break all generational curses that have passed down to them. Remove all and loosen all demonic forces that are trying to claim our children in any way, shape, or form. Lord, we thank you tonight that through the blood, we pray for our sons and daughters, that they would fear you, and from now on, righteousness would be the inheritance of our family and children, and our children's children. Lord, we pray and we surrender all our children, that they will receive you as their personal savior, even at an early age. Lord, place within his or her heart a desire to follow you all the days of their lives. Keep them pure and willing to wait on you so that his or her life would bring glory to you. And we ask that you would give them wisdom and give us the wisdom to train them and train them in the ways that they should go according to your word. Father, as we receive and welcome each of our children as a delightful blessing from you, and we speak your blessing upon them and over them, children, we bless you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, proclaiming the blessings of God, our Redeemer, upon each and every one of them. May he give them wisdom and refer faith of God, that the heart of love. Also, may he create in them a desire to attend to his works, a willing and obedient heart. May your eyes look straight ahead with purpose for the future. May your tongue be a pen of mercy and kindness to one another. May you speak the truth in love. May your hands do the work of unto the Father. May your feet walk the paths that God has ordained for you. May the Father, through his Son Jesus, prepare our children to walk into their future. We pray that all their souls will prosper and be in good health. Father, Mother God, our hearts are grieving also for those who are lost, those who do not yet know who you are, and they are in the hands of the enemy, and they don't know it. What can we do, Father? Isaiah 54:13 says, I will teach all your children, and they will enjoy great peace. Please use us to shine your light of truth to them. Lord, we wish that they could see what we see and know what we know. Give us the words to speak to them. We pray for their minds, that they will seek wisdom and understanding only through your word. Father, Mother God, we ask this night for a special revival and covering on all our children and youth throughout the entire world. Cover them with the precious blood of Jesus Christ, that no harm may come near their dwellings, that when they call upon you, you will answer them. Father God, we pray and we ask this and in no other name tonight, but in the precious name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we ask protection, guidance over all our world's children. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Sister Cheryl.
Hello?
Yes, we can hear.
Eternal God, we come humbly before you today just to say thank you for waking us up today and for allowing us to see another day on earth. I pray that, I'm going to start over. Heavenly Father, thank you for waking us up today and for allowing us to see another day. I pray that we will use our time wisely, because you have numbered our days and we aren't supposed to live on this earth forever. So I pray that every day that you give to us, that we will use it wisely and that we will do your will and glorify you with every second, every hour, every minute. I pray for the words of our mouths, that we will say kind words and say words that glorify you and words that are beneficial for building up and not tearing down. I bring before you today the young adults, God. There are few young adults in the church, but there are a lot of young adults in the world. So I pray, God, that you will send more young people and more young adults to the church. And I pray that if the church has hurt them in any way, that they will find it in their hearts to forgive and to remember that it is not our work that we do, but yours. I pray for the young adults that if they're struggling with anything like depression and anxiety or fear, confusion, they feel lost, lonely, they feel like they have nowhere to call home. God, I ask that you will meet them where they are and give them comfort and give them peace and just let them know that everything's gonna be all right. I pray for the church that they would welcome young adults with open arms. I pray for the church and the young adults that there will be a unity and an understanding between generations, no matter how old or young that we are. I ask that there be unity between generations and that generations work together for you to get your work done. God, I just want to thank you for allowing me to be on here and to be able to pray and to be able to come into your presence and ask you to do things that literally can change the world. Thank you for literally just being so humble as to allow a mere human as myself to be in your presence, God. I pray that you equip all young adults with confidence and boldness and courage to do your will. I pray that you soften our hearts so that we can surrender to you and not surrender to the things of the world, because it's easy to get distracted in this world and to lose sight of you, because like everything seems so fine and dandy until you actually get in it. But I just want to say thank you for, even when we get distracted, you still bring us back. You still bring us back home to you. And I just want to say thank you. I just pray the world, I just pray for unity, honestly. And I continue want to thank you for being with us. And yeah, this I pray in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you. Thank you so very much for all of those wonderful intercessory prayers. We're going to take a musical break. And when we come back, we will pray for the unity of the body of Christ. And then we will also receive individual prayer requests.
Throne unto his own. Jesus the King. Majesty, worship this man.
Amen. Majesty. I'm not sure if Brother Oscar is tuned in. Brother Oscar, can you hear me? Brother Oscar, could you unmute yourself, please? I'm not sure if he can hear me. And so I'm gonna move on to another, I'm gonna move on to Sister Yolande. Sister Yolande, would you offer prayer for the unity of the body of Christ? And after Sister Yolanda's prayer, we are going to receive individual prayer requests for self or family members or any other topic that you might have.
It's me, Pastor.
Okay, I'm gonna stick with Sister Yolanda then.
Okay.
Thank you.
Miracle worker, come and do a miracle today. You will do a miracle today. Oh God and our Heavenly Father, you know us well. You know the thoughts conceived in our hearts before we even vocalize them. We know that we can come to you for every need of life. Tonight, O Heavenly Father, we are asking for a special anointing on your children, our brothers and our sisters. Tonight we are praying, dear Heavenly Father, that you would bring unity among us, because we all know that when we unite, then there is strength and that we can also help each other. Oh Heavenly Father, we are calling upon you because we know you are our Jehovah Rapha, the God who heals. And if we can reach out to you to heal our hearts, then we know that we will be able to reach out to each other to help each other along the way and help each other to work with each other. Heavenly Father, we thank you for all your many blessings that you give us. We thank you for bringing us together this way to pray, to reach out to you, and to pray for each other. This we ask in and through your precious name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank you so much. So at this time, I will take prayer requests. If you brought a name of a beloved one who's struggling in any way that is in need of prayer, just remember to unmute yourself and say the name out loud.
Pastor, I'm requesting prayer for my brother who just lost his wife in Jamaica. His name is Ronald.
Ronald, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
On my cousin,
mm-hmm.
who just died also, so I lost two people.
Yeah.
Pray for the family. Yeah.
What's the name of the disease?
Her name is Gloria.
Okay. Thank you.
I ask for prayer for my friend, Carol mm-hmm. Wilson.
Okay. More prayer requests.
Good night.
All family.
Prayers for Mr. John Hall and
John
Beatrice
Hall.
Taylor.
Okay. John
Beatrice
Hall.
Beatrice Taylor.
Beatrice Taylor.
And Veronica Wilson.
Veronica Wilson.
She is in a nursing home over 2 years.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Veronica.
Yes. What's the name again?
Veronica.
Veronica, okay. Okay.
Do you have anybody to pray for?
There is a request for prayer for the unemployed and underemployed.
It's Brother Raymond is here.
Yes.
I also pray for the family of Sister Mary Bishop. She was the assistant to our Congresswoman Yvette Clark. She passed away. Her family.
Right.
You know, she was a stalwart in the community. She went to St. Mark's numerous mm-hmm. times over the years since Yvette Clark, Honorable Yvette Clark, was a city council member. So that's a number of years, over 20 years. She's well known in St. Mark's. Her funeral take place this Monday coming at Holy Innocent Church at East 18th and Bedford Avenue. Mm-hmm. At 5 o'clock, it's a viewing and funeral service at 7. Yeah. I also ask a prayer for two members, male members of the choir who haven't been around for a while, Hugh Johnson and Des Bourne Prince. We hope that they're
Can you say the first name that you mentioned?
Hugh Johnson.
Okay.
And you know he has had some health issues in the past mm-hmm. and has stopped coming to the choir and the church. Mm-hmm. So we have prayer for him and also Des Bourne Prince.
Des Bourne Prince.
Des Bourne Prince.
Okay. Got it. And also prayers are needed for the family of our deceased member of the church, Hermia Chica Biron. Hermia Chica Biron, she will have her service, her funeral service will take place at Frank J. Baron Funeral Home at 4502 Avenue D. Here in Brooklyn on May 22nd from 4 to 6 p.m. Let us hold her son and her family in prayers as well. More prayer requests?
For my brother, Keith Fennell, who is in a nursing home mm-hmm. in Kansas City, Missouri.
Okay.
Let's pray for Julia Theobalds.
Mm-hmm.
Julia Theobalds.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Perfect.
And Inez Stewart also. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Florence Williams.
Florence Williams.
Yes.
Okay. More prayer, more names, or more issues to pray for?
Prayer.
Delilah Fields.
Delilah Fields. Okay.
Hassan Brinson. He's in Kings Highway Hospital.
What's his name again?
Hassan. H-A-S-A-N.
Okay.
Brinson.
Mm-hmm. Hassan Brinson. Okay.
Let's also remember to pray, to continue to pray for Janet De Silva and Haiti Pitts' family. Yes. Also. Lloyd Mills, he's trying to remember some of the older members of our church. Lloyd Mills also, he's one of the members of our church. Mm-hmm. And Geraldine Locke, she also,
mm-hmm.
some of the members of the church.
Lois, who?
Lloyd Mills is his name. Lloyd Mills.
Okay. Do we have any more prayer requests?
Pat Finch.
Who?
Pat Finch, Patricia okay. Finch.
What's the last name?
Finch.
Okay.
F-I-N-C-H, Finch.
Got it.
Remember Sister Tessa Persico.
Sister Persico. Tessa Persico.
Yeah, Tessa.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
God via Nesbitt. Oh, God via Nesbitt. Yes, we need to keep her in prayer also.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
O'Shane Rose.
Faye Rose.
O'Shane Rose.
O'Shane Rose. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Asking for prayers for the Cargill family
mm-hmm.
on the passing of Ricardo Lamar Cargill to a horrible car accident.
Yeah.
On May the 12th.
Oh, okay. Okay.
And the Hospitalis family in Trinidad. Yes, Hospitalis, my aunt.
Okay.
And her family.
Right. Thank you.
I'm also going to ask prayer for my family, because we can always use prayer. So I'm asking prayer for my family.
Yes, Olivia Edwards.
Edwards Archer Babb family.
Okay.
Prayer for the Quissicos.
Yes, thank you. Can we also continue to pray for the gun violence?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. All right. And of course, I have with me a long list of names that we have been praying for from day one. I have all of them here. They are not forgotten. So we are just adding more names. Okay. So I'm going to ask for two volunteers. I'm not gonna mention your name. Mm-hmm. If you feel so moved in your heart, I'm gonna ask you to offer prayers for all these names that we have mentioned. Two people will pray for all these names before we have the closing. Just remember to unmute yourself and just go right ahead and offer your prayer. Hearing none, I will ask some specific people. Sister Marjorie Suttle, are you there? Could you be one of the volunteers, as yes. well as Sister Eileen, Eileen after Marjorie?
Let us pray. Mm-hmm. Heavenly Father, we come before you one more time to bless you, your name, to recognize who you are. You are God Almighty. You are in control. Lord, all the names that were mentioned here tonight, we ask you, Lord God, to touch their special needs. Whatever is the problem, whether it be sickness, pain, whatever they're suffering from, we ask you, Lord God, that you put a special touch to their needs. Lord, we depend on you for everything. We know that you give us the promises of your healing. You know that by your stripes, you said that we are healed. Lord, let us exercise our faith in declaring that healing. Let us use our words to claim that healing. Give us that faith to wait on you. Lord God, we thank you in advance for all that you are doing, going to do. We pray and bless in the name of Jesus, your Son, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Almighty God, Heavenly Father, we bring before you all those who were mentioned this evening. Mm. We ask your God to look after them, to heal them. Mm. Those who are ill, Lord, in body, we ask your Heavenly Father, the great physician, to heal them. Mm. We ask your Lord to be with those who are bereaved, those who have lost loved ones. Mm. We know it's not easy. We know that you can comfort. You are our help. You are our deliverer. Mm. And we know that it's only through you that healing can come about, and that comfort, that great comfort which we all crave, can come about. Lord, we ask you also not only to help those who are ill and to comfort those who are grieving, but Lord, there are so many ailments or so much hate in this world. There is so much going on. There is violence and just things that are not right. And there's so much injustice going on, Lord. We ask you to heal the land. Give us compassion. Give us love. Let us learn to be our brothers and sisters' keepers. Let us learn to be a family. Heavenly Father, bring us back to you. Bring us back to you. So many of us have strayed, and we don't know what it's like to love and to have compassion anymore. We ask you, Heavenly Father, to heal our communities.
Yes.
Heal us of all the hate, all the violence, all the wrong things that are going on in our societies, the injustice. Oh, Heavenly Father, bring us back to you. We ask your God to be with us. We thank you for being with us through this last year in particular, and for sparing us, and for just being there and delivering us, and just helping us to get through this. Many of us are still in dire need. Many of us are still suffering. Some of us still don't have a job. Some of us don't have a good home. Many of us are still wanting. We also pray for the people in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, Lord. They are still suffering. Yes, we have had a lot of help, but there are those who are still not able to return to their homes because they don't have anywhere to go back to. Mm. Many homes have been destroyed. Livelihoods have been taken away. The lands have been destroyed by the volcano. And we are still suffering, Lord. We are a people who are still suffering. We ask you to be with us. Be with those who are still affected by this terrible coronavirus disease. And we know that you, Lord, are the only one to whom we can look for comfort, for deliverance from all that we are suffering now. These, O Heavenly Father, we ask in the precious name of your dear Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And so we will, after this musical interval, we will have the closing remarks, and then we will call the day.
To Jesus I surrender.
I surrender all to Jesus. I surrender all. And so, my friends, I am so thankful that you have made time to join in and to log in into this week of prayers. How wonderful it is when brothers and sisters of faith come together in prayer to plead on the Lord. On our first day, on Tuesday, we had 30 sisters and brothers come together in prayer. On our second day, yesterday, Wednesday, we had 33 sisters and brothers come together and pray. And today, our closing day, we had 37 sisters and brothers come together and pray. You know, God is real, God is true, and God's promises are always truthful. God does not make false promises. He says, come to me and I will alleviate you from your burdens. Say, call on my name and I will be there for you. And so I honestly believe that God has heard our prayers and God will continue to hear our prayers, because I don't know about you, but as far as I'm concerned, you see all this list of names plus the list of yesterday, it's all here. And the list of names that we brought to the Lord on the first day, it's all here. And I will continue to pray over these names every day. And so, beloved, thank you for making the time. Thank you. And please do continue to be on your knees. Continue to pray to the Lord, and God will hear our prayers. God is honest and faithful. I see Peter's family and friends, Laverne Munro's family. I see all those names, the aged, praying for the aged. And so all of those are noted. And we will continue to intercede for all these prayer requests to the Lord. We will do so individually, and we will continue to do so collectively as a body of Christ. May God bless you and keep you, and may God continue to shower you with blessings, the blessings of peace and love, the blessings of joy and good health and recovery from your illnesses. God, who is faithful, sees you and knows your struggles. God is with us. And we shall not despair, we shall not lose heart or give up on the Lord. For he loves us and he died on the cross for us. And the Lord is seated on the right hand of his heavenly Father, interceding for us and for our needs. So we shall continue to stand and to march on, and we shall continue to declare victory over all troubles and tribulations in our lives. And so, beloved, I will go ahead and offer you a benediction now, and then we will have our dismissal song after this benediction. Let us pray. To God, who is Father and Son and Holy Spirit, to God be the honor and glory, mighty joy, worship, and all knees shall bow to the same God. Lord, we confess our sins and we ask for your forgiveness. Lord, we proclaim that liberty and freedom has come to our homes. Lord, you have placed us in our places of dwelling for a reason, because you need the blessings to come directly to our apartments and to our individual houses. We pray now blessings from you, O God Almighty, to be released from heaven and to come into every home, every apartment, and every place where your children dwell. Wherever your children find themselves right now, whether it's a nursing home or hospital, we are claiming and sending blessings in the name of Jesus. Lord, may you receive every prayer that has been brought unto you. May you remember every name, even those that we as humans did not remember to mention tonight. May you, O God, who knows everything, whose greatness goes and transcends our human understanding, whose greatness and existence transpires and transcends oceans and land and seas and even the space, whose greatness and presence is so mighty that no single person can accurately contain or contemplate your greatness. May you, O God Almighty, fill our hearts, fill our minds and our souls with your everlasting presence, so that not only tonight, but every day of our living, we shall be protected, be kept safe, and we shall be showered by the blessings of the Holy Spirit that are translated into peace, into joy, and into love and forgiveness. God, our Father, God, our Redeemer, God, our Savior, be with us and walk with us today and all the days of our life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And so now we will listen to this closing song as we prepare to depart, but never to depart from the presence of God.
Be with me till we meet
God be with the children.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you again so very much. Stay safe.
To you too, Pastor.
Keep the faith and never give up. Never, ever give up. Keep the faith.
Hello. God bless you, Pastor.
Love you. Good night, everybody. Love you.
Good night, everyone.
Good night, everyone.
Hi,
Janet.
How are you?
It was a great time. I'm good. God bless everyone.